Hey yo, this is the Constructicon Mix Master. I just did Scrap, his buddy, and now I'm doing Mix. Here you go, G1 Transformers. Anyway, I'm messing around, but G1 Mix Master. Let's begin with his tech spec. This is going to be similar to Scrapper in a lot of ways, and I'm not going to reiterate it, but I'll just whip through this really quickly because I talked about pretty much what I wanted to say about Devastator and my feelings towards him and the G1 line in my Scrapper review. So let's do this fast. This will be a quickie. Character. I give Mixmaster a 4, and the reason I give Mixmaster a 4 is because I never really liked his character. I thought he was kind of a lunatic. He was real flaky and fruity, and Megatron would have him concoct acids to cut through cave walls and shoot through schools, and Mixmaster would just come up with some stupid line like, "Ooh, mix it up good, yay, mixy, mixy, mix." Yeah, that's dumb. I never really liked this character in G1. Later versions of him I do like in the Revenge of the Fallen, even though he really wasn't fleshed out, he just looks really cool. But anyway, that's that. So I'll give him a 4, just because I didn't really dig his original character, and I'm looking at the original toy. So his mold, I give an 8. I give his mold an 8 because it's decent for a G1 toy. I mean, this to me is a nicer truck than the Classics Optimus Prime I reviewed, which is a 3-year-old toy. Classic Deluxe, I should clarify, in case you didn't watch that review, not the Voyager. So yeah, I mean, for a G1, this is great. I think it's a great mold. I think it's a great. He's got a enough detail to keep me occupied and amused. He's got sculpting in here that is reminiscent of a mixing truck. He's got the grill, the lights, the whole shebang. He's got a spinning little drum, which is nice. They even molded in all the dispensing stuff. The thing where you put the thing, the hopper and the freaking sprue or whatever you want to call it. I don't know what that stuff's called. I'm not a construction guy, so I don't know. Wheels got some detail on them. I mean, it's decent. It's decent for this old of a toy. I dig it. And his robot mode is. It's basic but satisfying, so we'll get to that. His paint. I'm going to give him an 8 like I did Scrapper. I talked about it, and I like the neon green and purple color scheme. I don't know why. It catches my eye. It pleases me. I like it. And I like his yellow and black. I wish they all had some of that on them. Some of them do. I know Hook does. I think Scavenger does. Yeah, I'm looking over my Devastator over there. Maybe Longhaul's got a little bit of it, but I like the yellow and black striped kind of warning labels as well. So that's kind of cool about these guys. Alt mode, I give an 8 as well. This is a decent alt mode. I mean, he's got a truck cab. You know it's a truck cab. A little purple window up there. Six wheels, spinning drum. Everything I just talked about, very nice. Very nice alt mode, especially for an old toy like this. I really do like this. I like all of their alt modes, in fact. Let me go to transformation. Transformation, I give a 5-2, which is kind of high because basically. That's his transformation. I give it a 5 only because I'm basing transformation. I cannot base transformations on transformations like compared to, okay, his Mixmaster of Revenge of the Fallen line. That was ridiculous. That transformation had about 500 steps and 9 million things could go wrong, and it's nearly impossible to get back into vehicle mode. Whereas this is two flips and you got a robot. Now, 5 might be a little high, but I love the end result. And I do like the way these guys look. So they're proportioned. They look fine as robots. Okay, maybe 5's high, but whatever. Let's just stick with it for now. Robot mode. I give a 7 too. I love his robot mode. It doesn't articulate, but it looks nice sitting there. He's got all the goodies of what you want. A couple nice big purple Decepticon symbols. I like his little hood here, and this actually came with a double missile, but I don't have that right now, and I'm not digging it out of a giant shoebox full of G1 weaponry. Yeah, I think this is a decent robot mode. I'll give it a 7. I just like the way it looks. Articulation, he's got a 3, and only because the only thing you can really do is this and this. He's actually less articulate than Scrapper is, who I gave a 4 in articulation to, because you could at least bend him at the knee. And when I say you can bend Mixmaster at the knee, I mean at the knee as in singular. Both of his legs go at the same time. I wish they could have somehow just separated these pieces, or just made them two separate panels, one cut, one different little thing, and it would have been a lot better. But oh well, it's just old toy, so whatever. Quality control, I gotta give this guy a 9 in quality control. And most of my G1 Devastator guys are gonna get pretty high rankings in quality control because they're still functional. They're still in one piece. I've got tighter arms on this guy than I do on my classic Skywarp that I had to pay over $100 to get delivered to me because he's so friggin' rare. So I love this. I love the fact that this guy's still got tight joints for how old he is. This became pretty loose over time, but you're never gonna know that because he just stands there. I mean, if I pull him up, then yeah, his legs sometimes don't come with, but whatever. Yeah, I gotta go with 9 on these guys. I mean, they're all in great shape, and let me tell you, I played with these guys hardcore. I mean, I had these guys throttling the Autobots. I'm a Constructicon fan and a Devastator fan, and definitely a Decepticon fan over the Autobots. So I'm gonna get my blue streak out one day and show everybody the freaking carnage that these guys wreaked on them. And for them to even be in one piece is completely amazing over time and how much I played with these things. So yeah, I'm impressed with quality control. I give it a 9. Stickers are all. These are kind of shot. Scrappers were a little nicer, but he did most of my fighting for me when I was younger, so well, we'll leave it at that. Scrapper just commanded. Anyway, overall rating, I give him a 10. I give all the Constructicons are going to get a 10 in rating because you need them to all form Devastator, and I think if you're going to get a G1 toy, if you can only get one G1 toy, maybe that's the only one you're interested, or maybe it isn't, but if you want to just go back and get a little piece of history, get G1 Devastator. He's the first combiner. He started all the combiners, in my eyes at least, and it's to my knowledge at least. And I absolutely loved him. I got to give every one of his components a 10 because I give him a 10. So overall rating, Mixmaster, Generation 1, give him a 10.